My name is Martin Heumann of TecMate. We work closely with Honda Motor Corporation with regards to battery chargers and batteries. I thought we will tell you about the evolution of the batteries in the reintroduced Africa Twin. Now, the Africa Twin is a classic bike out of the 80s and 90s, which Honda have reintroduced in 2016. And it came with this battery. This is a YTZ14 or a YTZ14. And its footprint is 150 millimeters by 87 millimeters. What I mean by footprint, that's the footprint there. And the height is approximately 110. In 2018, it was replaced with a lithium battery. Now, the lithium battery's footprint is a little smaller, 112 millimeters by 70. Much smaller, and definitely you can see that there's no ways that this battery can fit where this one fits. This is an HY110 battery. Its power is 6 amp hours or 72 watt hours. This is a 11.8 amp hour battery. Now you would wonder, why would you replace 11.8 amp hour battery with a 6 amp hour battery? This is lead acid, this is lithium. Now lithium delivers a lot more cranking amps than lead acid, and it's actually a lot more efficient. So you need about half of the lead acid battery to really have an equivalent battery. Then in 2023, Honda decided to replace this battery with a different lithium manufacturer. And it's still a 6 amp hour battery, 72 watt hours, same size. Now the reason that I replaced that, this battery has protection in it. It protects against short circuit or the accidental short circuit. If you were changing the battery and you shorted out against the frame, it would pop a fuse on this board and then your battery is gone. Now, the biggest problem with most riders is that we forget to charge the battery and it's over-discharged, but the day you want to go and ride, you're in a hurry. So you want to quickly charge that battery. Maybe you jump it with a lithium jump pack or something like that. Now, what happens? This fuse blows. And that's a $500 mistake. Now, for Honda, that eventually became untenable because Honda is a very reliable brand. They really market themselves as a reliable vehicle manufacturer, which they are. But the battery let them down. So they changed to a different battery. Now, this battery has protection in it for over-discharge. If you discharge this battery below 8 volts, it's going to turn off. No voltage, you'll turn on the key, there's nothing. You have to charge the battery back up, and then it'll work again. So they've addressed the weakness of this protection system in this battery, and they changed the manufacturer. It's not a cheap battery. It's 6 amp hours, they're both 6 amp hours. This is actually the original battery of the Africa Twin here behind me. And this is the battery that I replaced it with because we're testing it. Now, let me show you where that battery resides. Since 2018, the battery for the Africa Twin has been placed behind this little toolbox, as Honda calls it. I call it a little distribution box because I put a socket here where I can easily charge the battery. Now you see the location of that. If you fit aftermarket crash bars and everything, you want that battery to last. You don't want it to fail every year and you have to take the whole bike apart in order to replace it. Now, the battery fits right there. Now as we've illustrated earlier, that space fits a battery with a footprint that's 112 millimeters across and 70 millimeters tall in that space. It cannot fit a larger battery at all. There is no space at all for another type of battery. Now that we've shown you where that battery resides, let me explain something about footprints. If you look at this battery here and you look at that battery, as I explained, this battery fits in that small little space and it's 110 millimeters tall, hence the name HY110. And there's no other battery but the new replacement that fits in that space perfectly. Now, there have been questions online where people have asked, can I replace this with a lead acid battery? Sure, you can, but you're not going to have the same performance. Firstly, the only battery that'll fit is this one here. It's a YTZ or YTZ7. It's a 6.3 amp hour lead acid battery. So equivalent to about 3 amp hours of this. Means it's about a half the power of this battery. Now, you can see it's slightly shorter, so you'll probably need some padding to put it in there, but I would not recommend you using that battery. And I'll show you on a meter the difference in voltage. Both these batteries are fully charged. This voltage is around 13.08 volts, and this voltage is around 13.8 volts. They've just been charged. So that's the difference. It holds a higher voltage. But as I explained before, this delivers twice the power that this one delivers. The original HY110 lithium battery weighs 1.36 kilograms, and it has electronic protection that adds to the weight. The replacement weighs 1.26 or 1.27 kilograms. And this is a 6 amp hour aftermarket without any electronics. And it's 1.17 kilograms. So there's no electronic protection in this unit. There's electronic protection in this one. Now this is a popular aftermarket product. And you can see with lithium, you get what you pay for. This is 685 grams. It's half the weight. It's a 2 amp hour battery. This is a 6 amp hour battery, 6 and 6, and that's 2. And that's the only one that'll fit in there, but it's not going to last. Now, of course, there are people that still suffer from sticker shock when they see the price of a replacement OEM battery. Now, bear in mind that inside this battery is protection to protect your investment. You can get cost-effective batteries like these two. This is a direct size-for-size replacement, in fact, made in the same factory as this one, but this has no protection. It'll cost less, but no protection. And then this is a common aftermarket model. As you can see, similar footprint, similar size. It's the only one of the NOCO batteries, the NLP5, that'll fit in that space. But this is a 2 amp hour battery. It's rated at 27 watt hours. Pay less, get less. I would always go with the OEM version. There are some misconceptions around lithium where online you might get the wrong advice, where people would say, you don't need to charge your lithium battery. Now, while it's sitting here, not connected to your vehicle, you don't need to charge this battery maybe for a year, up to 18 months, okay? It has a very low self-discharge. But once it's in the vehicle, it's going to slowly drain because the vehicle drains the battery. And the one tip that you have to adhere to is do not let this battery discharge below 30%. Which in voltage equivalent is exactly 13 volts. Once you start dropping below that voltage, the battery is below 30% and it will not deliver the cranking amps that you expect. Now, once it drops below 12 volts, 11 volts, 10 volts, you are in danger of damaging your battery. Now, big difference between lithium and lead acid batteries If you want to keep this guy healthy, you need to maintain it 24/7, every single day. This battery only needs to be maintained maybe once a week or so. But no one wants to go into their garage and every once a week set an alarm and connect the battery up. That's why we have smart chargers that Honda recommend. This is actually a Honda branded charger that is sold by American Honda. This is our TM470 series 0.8 amp lithium charger. This is our 6 amp lithium charger. It's the new one that Honda recommends. It's our TM390 series. Now, if you look in your manual, you'll see some part numbers like TM290, which is the predecessor of this charger. This replaces the TM290. It's the TM390. It's a 6 amp charger. Good thing about lithium batteries, they can be charged pretty fast. They don't mind being charged fast. So within an hour or two, you can be ready to go. And you don't need to charge it to 100% before you go riding. Just have enough charge between 30 or 50%, start the engine and off you go. Now, when you leave these chargers on the battery, it monitors this battery in the bike. And if it drops below about 70%, then it will maintain the battery and bring it back up to around 90. And that'll continue maybe once a week or so, it's going to do that. So it's not delivering charge every day, only when the battery needs it. And that's the difference between lithium and lead acid. This guy is going to get charged on an hourly basis. This guy is going to get charged maybe once a week. In this 2021 model, I have the new OEM battery. We received two batteries that we were testing. One is in this bike, and this is what it sounds like. Starts without a problem. That's why stick with your OEM battery, or at least get a 6 amp hour lithium replacement battery. Smaller than that, you're going to have problems. And when you park the bike, plug in your TecMate lithium battery charger and let it do its job and save you money.